Hey!
Yes! Yes!
Hello! Welcome to Mono Majority TV Night! I believe the first of its kind. And like Mono Majority, we are the New York City's first Asian American sketch comedy team.
Yes!
And we've been in Time Out in New York and most recently New York Times recommended. So thank you for all the people who came because of the New York Times. So what we do is special. So every show, we make a new show in a very, very short amount of time with very little money. And we write, direct, and produce the show with all Asian American people because we are just as funny and talented as anybody else. And we deserve a TV show.
Yes.
Yeah.
So tonight you'll get a taste of it, seeing TV shows you may or may not know with an all Asian American cast. And Carol has some more things to tell you about our show.
So thank you all for joining us tonight. As like a gesture of our thanks, we have some giveaways lined up for everyone. And just make sure to pay attention because we'll be giving more details about that later. And also, for you guys watching live with us, you got a shot at extra entries, so definitely pay attention. And if you have any questions, throw it in the chat. And if you want to know more about all the sketches you're watching, like who wrote it, who's in it, name of the sketch, you can get all of that info at our website, modelmajority.com. And there's a tab for TV nights, so just click on that and you'll get to see all the wonderful people involved and how they helped make this all possible.
And you should definitely check it because Carol put a lot of work into it. So you're in for that, just a supporter for that. Thank you, Carol, for doing all the graphics. Also, since we can't be with you live, if you chat with us, we'll chat back when we're not performing. And we want to hear, like, where are you from? Where in the world are you from? Because apparently we have people. And I want to see who came from the furthest to come watch. And let's start our show. Monica.
Yep, so to kick off our show, I want to introduce our special guest, the Black Pantherettes. They are a New York-based all-Black female comedy troupe with their own web series. You can check it out on www.blackpantherettes.com. And the following video is from their web series, so let's watch the video now.
Woo!
Woo-hoo!
Megan? I know you need a comeback, but this ain't it, all right?
One minute till tight, Miss Kelly.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Katie, you're my assistant. And last time I checked, I make the bad decisions around here.
All right.
All right. Oh, sorry, babe. You and I make the decisions around here. Hello, and welcome to a new episode of Megan Kelly Loves the Hood Live, my new variety show on YouTube. As you all may remember, I was unjustly fired for saying blackface is okay. It is not. I love black people. To prove it, I've secured a very special singer for today's show, none other than my friend, Robert Kelly, a.k.a. R. Kelly. He will be doing a very special performance of He's coming in now? Wait, with his girlfriend? It wasn't supposed to be that way.
I believe I can fake a cry. I think about it every night and day. Leave the country and run away.
Robert, hi. What's with the new song?
Oh, we live!
Yes!
Oh, I didn't know y'all heard that. I was just messing around with my girl. I mean, woman.
Oh, we definitely heard you.
Oh, Megan, look at you. Well, you haven't aged the business the last time I saw you at the Grammys.
Oh, wow.
Looking like you 17.
Oh, it's Robert.
It seems like you're ready.
Ready for what?
Excuse me.
Everybody, hey, sit down. Sit down.
Robert, I didn't know you were bringing Stacy. Stacy is Robert's girlfriend. She's been with him for 10 years. She's really old.
I'm 35 years young.
Baby, let me see that ID.
Yeah.
Oh, she's telling the truth, guys. Telling the truth.
Let's get to it. Now, you're up against some pretty serious accusations. I mean, I know what it's like to be crucified in the public eye, no matter how many times you've contributed to society. But I mean, Robert, what do you have to say about these charges?
Come on, Megan, now you know me. I'm a flirt.
Oh.
So if I'm guilty, it's because of that.
Robert, yes. Oh, Robert, this is serious.
Snow Bunny, can we talk about this more off the record?
Yeah.
Because I don't see nothing wrong with a little bump and grind. I don't see.
Promise me. Oh.
No more recruiting other girls. I am your main chick. I am your main chick.
You got one more time, Robert.
No. Oh, no. Oh, God, no.
I told you this was a bad idea. Mr.
Oh,
Kelly,
God.
You can leave.
Ladies,
bye.
Can you please just calm down, all right? I'm just talking to the woman. You ain't got to be grabbing me up like that.
Damn.
Can you just ask another question?
Moving on. Now there seems to be another tape that's circulating with another minor. But I mean, come on. How stupid would you have to be to put your misdeeds on tape?
Oh, right.
Yes.
Megan, now do I look like a videographer?
No.
I've got arthritis. I can't even hold a camcorder or a camcorder bag. Someone, hand me something. Okay. Hand me something. Pick up the camcorder bag. See?
Oh.
Drop.
Mm-hmm. Drop in 10 miles.
What is this? Wait, R. Kelly P's?
I'm not trying to be rude, but Miss Kelly, I'm feeling you. The way you talk on the screen makes my body roll and sing.
It's the remix to Ignition. No. Hot and fresh out the kitchen. No. Mama
no,
ruling
stop,
my body.
Stop your singing.
Oh, that's a good song.
Stop your dancing. Robert, it's true, isn't it?
Ding dong.
How could you do this to me? I was attracted to you. I advocated for you.
Oh, Megan. Now, I know it looks bad, but me and you, we both misunderstood. But we could just run off, start fresh.
And keep it on the down low.
Oh, my gosh.
Megan, finish the show, girl. Bring it over. Come on.
Well, that's it for today's show of Megan Kelly Loves the Hood Live. Tune in next week for my, what are you talking about? I wasn't flirting with him, I swear. Baby, please, I can't do the show without you. What? Oh, my God, no. What do you mean?
Oh, well, I guess the court could use this. You want half?
Thank you, Black Pantherettes. Great job, so funny, and Megyn Kelly never looked better. Next up, normally I don't like to go to HR, but there is one exception. Welcome, Gary from HR.
Hey. Oh my gosh, thank you, Model Majority, for having us. Hey, everybody. We are Gary from HR. We are a sketch team that was assembled by the Magnet Theater in New York City, and we are the first house sketch team in New York City to be written, directed, and performed exclusively by people of color. So if you want to check us out, follow us on our socials. You can check us out at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Gary from HR. We're also on YouTube, where we have our whole catalog of videos on Gary from HR Sketch. And now, because this is HR, and I don't really think you've complied with everything, I'm going to send you over to Janae's office.
Boop, boop, boop.
Okay, and if you didn't know, members of our team have worked in front of the camera and behind the camera on major networks like Netflix, Nickelodeon. They've had principal roles and have worked with David Fincher. Additionally, we've had ad campaigns where a number of our team members have participated, namely Procter & Gamble and M&M's, and we know everyone loves M&M's, you know what I'm saying? It's a great snack for the day when you've been really tired and stressed out and filing paperwork, dealing with employee conflict, but that's nor here nor there, right? We've also written for Reductress and have also gotten awards, namely the Scholastic Writing and Art Award. So now, I still don't think you have complied, so I will send you down the hall to my friend Greg.
No, you're not in trouble, but I do need to let you know that you can catch Chanika on IG at Chanika Carey and Janae Bates at J.Bates and me, Greg Emanuel, on IG and Cash App. Right now, we're going to see a video because we have to meet our video quota, even though HR departments haven't been as busy as they can be because of the pandemic. So we're going to show a video now on how to deal with harassment using a service dog. Enjoy.
Come on, Butterscotch. You're making Mommy Brittany late.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please. Oh.
Hey, Mommy Brittany, you shouldn't be bringing dogs on the train. It's not hygienic.
Oh, my baby Butterscotch is clean. She's my service dog. She protects me from people like you.
Like me? Well, I got my own service dog, too. Hey, yo, D! Did it.
Hey, yo! It's the dog DMX. Leave my girl Tanyika alone.
What's a DMX?
He's my service dog. He protects me from people like you. Thank you for your service, dog.
Yo, Butterscotch, you're my dog now.
Thank you so much, Gary from HR, for joining us tonight. And with that poignant and brilliant video, as an adult, I feel like we all need a service dog because I can't do anything correctly because I'm not an adult. With that being said, live from New York, it's Model Majority TV night on Zoom.
Just talked this morning.
She says it's an emergency. The dishwasher is broken or something like that.
How is that an emergency? It's just a drying rack anyways.
How do I get this thing to work?
Dad, we just did this. Click the video button.
What?
Ma, you're on mute. Yeah.
Don't tell her.
I heard that, Deborah. Ray, sweetie, you don't look so good. Are you okay? Is it Deb's cooking? You know what? Let me come over and feed you.
Do we need to do this every call?
We've been over this, this new thing they call the quarantine. I can't come over there.
But it's my lasagna.
Ma, you can't do it. Wait, the sauce is lasagna.
Ray?
You know what? I'll bring it over.
Okay, no, Ma, you can't come over.
I got it. But where did you all go?
You gotta press gallery view.
What?
Gallery view. Do I need to come up to your room?
Why don't you all just use the same computer since you all live in the same house?
Frank wants to watch TV in the other room, and Roberta never leaves the basement, well, except for meals.
Ma?
Ma, I'm trying to get some work done at home. You called and you said it was an emergency.
How are you her favorite child? You're always whining when she asks you for something.
Don't talk to your brother like that. And the toilet is clogged. Your father broke his back again trying to fix it.
What? Dad, are you going to be okay?
What? My back is fine. Just let me watch the game.
I thought it was the dishwasher.
Wait, why do we need to fix the drying rack?
Dad looks fine. You look fine, Dad. Ma. Hello, Ma. Ma, you're frozen again. She's frozen.
This is a waste of time. She just wants attention.
Ha ha! I wasn't really frozen. I was testing you. I knew you'd talk behind my back.
Don't listen to her. She's just trying to change the subject.
Shut up, Frank.
Hey. Ma.
Calm down.
Are you all trying to send me to an early grave? How could you do this to me, your own mother?
What did I do?
Not the golden child now, are you?
And you, when are you going to give me grandchildren?
When you stop guilting me into living in your basement, which you charge me rent for.
Just put a sock in the door if you have a gentleman caller.
No, Ma. Gross. Ma.
Yeah. Leave them alone and let me watch the game in peace.
That game's from 1992. You already know what happens.
Clearly, nothing's wrong. I'm gonna go make dinner.
What about my lasagna?
We'll be fine, Marie. Good night.
Ma, could you leave lasagna on the porch?
My name is Organic, and I'm an ergonomics consultant.
And I'm Thomas, and I play a pan flute in a band called Melodious Blowhards.
And our lease is up.
And we're looking for a new home.
A tiny home. We're looking for a tiny home.
I'm Jamanza, and today we have a variety of tiny homes for Organic and Thomas. We're going to start with a really rustic cabin that was actually made with Lincoln's logs. This is one of our nicer tiny homes. It has a roof and 2 points of egress. There's a really cozy floor space as well.
Where's the bathroom?
You actually have a 2,000 square foot bathroom right out that back door.
Does it have any ghosts?
Not that I know of.
Ugh, how boring. Let's see what else you've got.
Now, this property just opened up, so you two are one of the first to see it.
Oh, it looks like a hobbit hole. Frodo could be our neighbor.
It has the added bonus of a freshwater stream just beyond that tree.
I don't know. It looks a little big.
Well, it's just 200 square feet.
Yikes, we said tiny home, Jamanza.
And what is that terrible noise?
Is it the stream? There's fresh water right by that stream.
It sounds like it's mocking me. Is it mocking me?
Yeah. Streams are a little bit too nouveau for my taste.
Okay. I think I have just the place for you. This is one of our more remote properties.
I get a really good vibe from this place.
Not too cold, not too hot, just right.
There are no neighbors, so it's nice and quiet, but there are some ghosts from dead miners that come around every fortnight.
Ugh, perfect. Can we, like, close up that entrance a bit? There's a draft.
Sure, there's no building codes for this place.
I'm feeling really good. I want to put up an offer.
It's 3.4 million.
What a steal. Daddy can wire me that tonight.
Yeah, so he can go ahead and wire that straight to me. The shaft is yours.
Honey, did we find our new tiny home?
I think we did.
And that's how I sold an abandoned mine shaft to a bunch of idiots.
As part of its Christmas in July lineup, the Hallmark Channel is pleased to present a new original movie. Erica was a big-time publisher who wouldn't give in to the Christmas spirit.
I don't care if it's the holidays. I need the final draft of his novel by Friday.
Colin was her childhood best friend, who now runs a bakery back home in Chinatown.
Is your pork bill miss? And no worries, it's all me. Merry Christmas.
They haven't seen each other in years, but all that's about to change when fate brings Erica home for the holidays.
Erica, I have sprained both my wrists, and now I need your help for the holiday parties at our struggling dim sum restaurant. You'll be working with Colin, who coincidentally supplies all the desserts for the restaurant.
It's love at first bite for these two old friends.
Oh, Erica, so wonderful to have you back home in Chinatown. Even though you're only 8 stops off the F line and could have easily visited whenever you wanted to.
I know, Colin, but now that I like you as more than a friend, I'm going to give up my lucrative job in publishing to run a business I know absolutely nothing about.
But the Christmas miracles don't end there.
You know, I never told you this before, but I'm actually a prince. And I would be honored if you became my princess.
Wait, Erica, what about me? Your fiancé? We're already engaged.
Sorry, Tyler, but everyone knows that the workaholic boyfriend never gets the girl in our movies.
What? But I'm rich. I always get the girl.
Did you not hear what I just said? It's the Christmas movie that panders to an audience we usually ignore. It's A Very Dim Sum Christmas, tonight at 8. Be sure to keep buying our $20 greeting cards.
Hello, friend. To break free from the White Rose's control, it all begins with this.
The Department of Labor? Do you know who you're dealing with? Their system can't handle this kind of volume.
Website under maintenance between 7:30 and 7:30.
This is the United States government we're dealing with, not Evil Core.
He's right. Their system hasn't been updated since Y2K. I haven't seen anything like this.
19 million people are trying to do the same thing you are right now. Think, Elliot!
I have the entire Dark Army at my disposal. All I have to do is call.
Hello, is anyone there? I can hear you eating. Who is this? I need access to a government server. I just heard you take another bite. I know you heard me. Do it.
I'm in.
That was the easy part. Please call the Department of Labor to finish your application.
That's a human firewall. He's right. I'm out of my league.
You are not even halfway there. The algorithm says it could take up to 2,000 tries just to get an answer.
It's not even ringing. Unhackable. Unless I reroute the call from inside the mainframe. Something different is happening. I have an estimated wait time of 6 minutes. Now they're saying it's 6 days? If you would like to leave a callback number, the line is disconnected.
Not as easy as you thought, huh, Elliot?
The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over but expecting different results. Human activity.
Hello, New York Department of Labor. Please hold.
This can't be real. I must be asleep.
White Rose is calling. She's onto your plan. You just answered White Rose's call!
I panicked. I was afraid I was going to accidentally hang up on the Department of Labor.
Elliot, my sources tell me that you're trying to get financed by the U.S. government.
I don't need you or your resources. I'm applying for unemployment.
Huh. Good luck trying to get through to a live person. Do you have what it takes to call someone 2,000 times?
I don't have to call anymore. I already made my first contact. In fact, they just put me on hold.
They could be trying to talk to you right now. Elliot, hang up! You just hung up on both of them, didn't you?
I'm going back to working for the White Rose. Goodbye, friend.
Hello. I can't come to the phone right now. Please wait while I put you on hold for hanging up on me.
I'm not on hold. I can hear you chewing.
Hey, you came to the wrong place.
Tired of watching sports reruns on ESPN? Disney's ESPN Plus presents The Mandalorian Plus.
So you really don't take off your helmet?
No.
What about when you want to, shoot your missile into her Sarlacc pit?
Baby Yoda says his first words.
He has spoken.
We've got more stormtroopers, more Easter eggs, and more scenes that will make you wonder if it's just a stunt double under that costume and it's all just voiceovers. We'll have a pre- and post-show coverage with our top Mandalorian analysts breaking down each scene. Special cameos by Iron Man, Rob Gronkowski, and the ghost of Babe Ruth. The Mandalorian Plus on ESPN Plus. May the Force be with you for $4.99 a month.
I can't believe Peter cheated on me with my twin sister, Tanya.
I can't believe my twin sister, Melissa, is dead.
Peter!
Tina, I didn't cheat on you. That was my twin brother, Paul. He was with Tanya.
Tina, I love you.
How could you, Paul?
Ooh. Melissa, I thought you were dead. I survived the surgery. No thanks to Peter, who tried to kill me.
No, that was also my twin brother, Paul.
Sorry, Melissa. That bomb was intended for Mary.
What did I ever do to you?
I asked you where Tanya was, and you pointed at Tina, trying to trick me.
So you'd try and kill me? I mean, it was a mistake. They're twins.
Mary, how could you? Mary, how could you,
Mary?
I mean, look at Tanya and Tina. You're telling me you can tell them apart?
Night and day.
Apples and oranges.
Well, that's Tina, that's Tanya. It's like night and day.
Tina, Tanya, who are you? I'm your sister, Trish. We're triplets, separated at birth. And Mary was pointing at me that day you were looking for Tanya. Ever since that day, I've fallen in love with you, Paul.
Well, Paul, looks like you need to choose. You slept with Tanya, confessed your love to Tina, and now Trish loves you too. He also tried to kill me. Hush, Mary.
Well, I'll definitely choose the most beautiful.
There is literally no difference between them.
I choose Peter.
What? Dude, you're my brother, man. Get out of here!
Ew, ah. Ew, mother!
Are you all having a good time? Good, because we are too. Thank you so much for being here. Well, if you're feeling good and you're feeling generous, you should head on over to naacpldf.org/donate, or you can look up or Google NAACP Legal Defense Fund and donate from there, all right? They are America's top legal firm fighting for racial justice. And that is very important. We need that. So you go on over there, you give them your money, and then you send us your receipts, all right? Then you'll be entered into a raffle where you could be chosen to receive a fun gift from Model Majority. And if you are the highest donor, you might receive an even more special gift. So you do your thing. All right. Take it away, Dewey.
Yes. Thanks, Nan. Hey, guys. Thanks for enjoying our show. Definitely follow us on social media for your chance to win a Model Majority hand sanitizer. Bah! Yes. Our Instagram is Model Majority. Our Twitter handle is Model Majority 1. And Facebook, like us on facebook.com, Model Majority Comedy, and YouTube is Model Majority Comedy as well. There will be a post on Facebook with all the details for you to follow and your chance to win. So thanks again, guys, for joining our show, and good luck. Hey, Alex, what's going on with you?
So, I am so excited to announce our September show, because we are partnering with Hoppa Mag. Some of you may know I am the editor-in-chief of this online magazine, and we are so excited to be celebrating our 3-year anniversary in September. So we are having a show September 18th, 8 p.m. with Model Majority, but the theme is mixed comedians and mixed comedy, and it's gonna be such a great night. We are so, so excited and grateful for this opportunity for presenting this night with you guys. So be sure to follow us on all our social medias and follow Hoppa Mag at the Hoppa Mag on Twitter and on Instagram and Facebook, and be sure to catch up with what we're doing. And I can't wait to see you guys in September. Back to our show.
What's the deal with Zoom? Zoom. You can live your entire life without ever showing off your bottom half. Which sucks for me, because I just got these new pants and now I can't show them off.
Speaking of Zoom, I'm pretty sure my boss is meeting the marketing assistant behind my back. I know he wants my job. She has all these recurring Zoom meetings without me.
Zoom meetings? Don't you mean Zoom dating for George?
What are you talking about?
Let me show you what I mean.
Where did you get that?
I present to you the Zuma Bomber.
You should definitely change that name.
I've written a program that collects every Zoom credential ever created. I can listen in on any Zoom meeting that ever was or will be. Conferences, workshops, corporate meetings. The only thing I don't Zoom bomb are Zoom orgies, because consent? It's sexy.
Maybe you should listen to a workshop about privacy leaks.
Can I use it to confront my boss about her secret meetings? She thinks she's so sneaky.
Of course.
Jerry, you must come on the next date with me. I have this woman convinced that I'm the most in-demand celebrity spiritual guru in New York. She thinks you're my client.
And why would she think that?
I may have told her.
George.
A woman has never been so into me. Knowing she would never see me in person just made me get bolder and bolder with my lies. Besides, this will be a perfect opportunity for you to show off those new pants.
No, I wouldn't have my career without George.
That's incredible, but we can't see your face.
Jerry, your pants are very nice. Now, will you please sit down?
I'm sorry I ever doubted you, Georgie. I'm so lucky I got to meet someone so amazing who knew Zoom dating could be so great.
Jerry, George, what are you doing here? And Melanie, This isn't a meeting with the marketing assistant.
Elaine?
You've been going on dates with George on company time, but you can't give me a raise? Does your husband know?
No, George.
You're married?
You're bald.
Oh, you were both catfishing each other.
We're not safe anymore!
What's wrong?
The code for Zuma Bomber has leaked! The information is out! Everyone everywhere is Zoom bombing! It's anarchy in the Zoomscape!
What are those?
Your knees are so thick.
Are you retaining water in your knees?
Those sad kneecaps are trying to bust out of those poor pants.
Jerry, you gotta get those knees checked out.
The woman at the store told me thick knees are cool.
It's been over 120 days since you last touched a person. Heard the table next to you gossip about a stranger's affair at brunch? Ate a slice of pizza without washing your hands? But remember, you're New York tough. That's right, you. We see you making masks to donate. You even called your elderly neighbor last week just to make sure that loud bang you heard wasn't her dying. And hey, we've all ordered an extra Amazon package or two just to have an excuse to try to talk to the FedEx guy. Don't worry, we are going to get through this together. Because together, we are New York tough. And together, 15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Wait, what?
Hi, Detective Jake Johnson. Just transferred to Special Victims from Ohio. You could call me Jake.
Okay.
Aren't you going to tell me your name?
What's the point? You're just going to call me Lab Tech anyways.
Right. Did you get the CCTV footage my partner sent over?
Yeah, because I know exactly what footage you're talking about, since it's not like I need a case number or evidence log info, and there aren't hundreds of open cases or anything.
Great. Let's see what you got. Stop. Zoom in on that. I can't read that. Do the thing.
The thing?
You know, the thing that makes it super clear?
That's not how it works. It's not like it's the blurry license plate of a speeding car.
Damn! He looks like he's enjoying that sandwich. And I want to know where it's from.
Don't you have to solve a crime or something?
Right. Let's keep going. Stop!
If this is another sandwich, I swear.
That looks like the victim. Who is that next to her? Ah, so blurry. I thought the NYPD would have a state-of-the-art forensics with a $6 billion budget. That's why I moved here from Cleveland.
That's the reason you wanted to leave Ohio, not the many other reasons?
Well, that and I'm chasing my little sister's killer. I'll never forget that night from 10 years ago. The way the crime scene looked, the smell. This case has the killer's M.O. written all over it.
New character backstory. Should have led with that. Here you go. Vic's face, the killer's face, and his car keys, which has a unique key fob, so now we have the make and model of the car. And putting algorithm into the system, it scanned through all the footage of those cars in New York. I've hacked the mainframe to redirect them towards the precinct. They're stuck at a red light down the block. More things.
Is this your number?
Ew, no. It's the case number.
I shall have my revenge.
Dude, we're in a windowless room.
Sunglasses are my thing.
I should have been a TV writer.
Cool Cats and Kittens, Carol Baskin here of Carol's Big Cat Rescue, and we have two very awesome updates for all our feline friends, don't we, Howard?
Yes, we do. Through the federal judge's ruling, we have acquired Joe Exotic's prison of a zoo. Rawr!
Rawr! Meow!
Before we give you the other possum news, we want to address the endangered elephant in the room.
Now, a lot of people have been spreading some ugly rumors about me and my husband, Howard.
Those gosh darn kids with the Facebooks and the Reddit conspiracies.
Howard, don't you shame the Redditors and their conspiracy theories. You know better than that.
Sorry.
Now, the world must know, because we cannot live this life any more.
We're excited to announce Carol Baskin-Robbins.
Trust us, you will be clawing to try our ice cream with flavors like French Vaccinella,
Illuminati Confetti,
Mint Chalocness Monster,
5G Green Tea,
Lizard People De Leche,
Biggie and Tupac Amisu,
JF Cake Batter,
Epstein Island Punch,
and of course, everybody's favorite, strawberry.
Mmm, it's so good it hurts because I'm lactose intolerant.
Howard, don't you dare spit up that ice cream now. Howard?
Excuse me, gotta go to the bathroom.
To see more videos of me and my posse, be sure to click the subscribe button. Otherwise, it will be catastrophic. Just kidding.
Cheers! My name is Inam Quazi, and today I'm going to tell you about Yayoi Kusama. Yayoi Kusama was born in Nagano, Japan in 1929. When she was 10 years old, she started seeing hallucinations of dots and flowers talking to her and fabric multiplying, which were all still part of her artistic vocabulary. You know, when she was moving to New York, she burned 2,000 of her paintings because she was like, I'm gonna make better art than any of this. I'm starting from scratch. So she does a group show with Klaus Oldenburg, who was a papier-mâché sculptor, and Yayoi showed her soft sculptures, you know, sculptures made of fabric. And then she goes to Oldenburg's next show and it's all soft sculptures. And she's like, what the fuck, man? Your sculptures are hard. I've seen them. My sculptures are soft. And Oldenburg's wife is like, I'm so sorry, Yayoi. And it's like, bitch, you knew. So then, at her next show, she does this thing where she covers the entire gallery walls with photos of her artwork. And Andy Warhol is like, wow, that's cool. So then, she shows up at Andy Warhol's next show, and his entire gallery wall is covered with prints of his work. And she's like, what the fuck? And everybody else is like, wow, Andy Warhol is a visionary. Then, she presents her first Infinity Mirror Room. And guess what? Some white man artist whose name I can't even remember right now, out of nowhere, presents his Infinity Mirror Room at a bigger gallery. And he was just like, all these white men are getting famous for my ideas. So she jumps out of her window, but lands on a bike and lives. So then she's like, well, I guess I just have to keep living and keep making art. So then she started doing these happenings, you know, performance art. And she, like, got a bunch of people naked in the MoMA Sculpture Garden to be like, what actually is modern about the MoMA with its white-ass paintings by white-ass men? And she also showed up at the Venice Biennale uninvited and sold these mirrored orbs with a sign that said, you can buy your own narcissism. And everybody was like, Ah, what an attention-seeking woman. By the time she decided that she was over the Western art world, Japan was like, no, we hate you, we don't want you either. And she got severely depressed, and in 1977, she checked herself into a hospital in Japan. And through the 70s and the 80s, she was virtually forgotten by all the art scenes that she contributed to. But she still kept making art at the hospital. And then one day, someone saw her art, and they were like, oh my god, she's a genius! Someone needs to see this! Ma'am, where have you been? So, this woman sets up Yayoi's retrospective in New York, and it is super successful. And now, she is the most successful living artist. She's like, I'm 91, and I'm still making art every day of my life. Suck it, Klaus Oldenburg. Yayoi Kusama was so ahead of her time. And all these white men just stole her shit and made it theirs. Will it ever change? You're gonna gram her, know her damn name.
Thank you, everybody, for coming to our show. Hey. These shows cannot be possible without you. So thank you to our fans. Thank you to our new fans. Thank you to our friends and family that support us. Not my parents, but everybody else's family. thank you to our amazing producing and tech team, Andy and Horacio. Thank you to Judy for doing some of our sound design. Thank you to the best comedy team in the world, Mama to Jordy. Thank you to the Pit for having us, and thank you to the New York Times. And Nan will remind you what you need to do next.
Yeah, you better keep opening your wallets and throw in money at the NAACP Legal Defense Fund. Yeah, open your wallets for racial justice. You go do that, okay? Carol, what do you have to say?
Just want to thank you all again for joining us tonight. And just to remind you that we have a couple of giveaways going on, including with Nan, and she mentioned earlier, for donating to the Legal Defense Fund. There is an entry for that. And then also a reminder that after this stream ends, there is going to be a post on our Facebook page with the giveaway info for the hand sanitizer that's Model Majority branded and approved. And remember to follow us on our social media. So that is Instagram is Model Majority, Twitter is Model Majority 1, and then on Facebook and YouTube, look for us at Model Majority Comedy. And what else? And the website, don't forget to check out our website, modelmajority.com, for more info on the show you saw tonight, for info on upcoming shows. And speaking of upcoming shows, Kevin?
Whoa! Our next show will be at the Jersey City Comedy Festival. That's when? August 13th, 7 p.m. Thursday. Check us out. Thursday, 7 p.m. Comedy Block. Model Majority. Go to the website, jerseycitycomedyfestival.com, and we'll see you there Thursday.
And then last but not least, for those who have signed up for the after party, you'll become partying it up with me, so please bring your dancing shoe for some groovy moves, and I'm here to pass it back up to our fearless leader, Veronica.
Thank you. Again, I'm so excited for this show, and it was only possible because of everybody who came to watch. And I would like to dedicate this show to Horacio's mom, Lorena Secunita Gutierrez. May she rest in peace. She's one of the funniest people I know and super supportive Model Majority, so this is for you. So let's go drink and eat. I'll see you at the after party. Thank you again. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Thank you guys for
love
coming.
You guys. Thank
Bye.
You for coming.
Thanks for support. We love you.
Bye, Chen. Keep donating.
Yes.
Yes.